مرحبا وأهلا وسهلا فيكم بدرس جديد. Hello and welcome to a new lesson in Levantine Lebanese colloquial or spoken Arabic brought to you by www.learningarabicwithangela.com. Today's lesson is going to be about directions, public and touristic places, countries and names of continents in Lebanese Arabic. اتجاهات والأماكن العامة والسياحية والبلدان والقارات. Before we start with the lesson, I'll just remind you that I've recently launched my Learn Lebanese course, which you can find by accessing this link here. So basically www.learningarabicwithangela.com/levantine-spoken-arabic. And it will basically get you to a strong A level in Lebanese. You don't have to know anything at all, not even how to read or write. Everything is transliterated and translated, and you'll get over 750 minutes of video, which is specially and specifically recorded for this course and privately recorded for this course, and it will get you through basics and phonetics before getting into conversation and mastering how to converse in Lebanese at this level, as well as lots of freebies. So you're going to get all the ebooks for all the lessons, including several other ebooks for intermediate level as well. So what you will get is a preparation for intermediate level, and you'll get stories, and you'll get access to a private chat group where you'll get to chat with me and ask me questions if you have any questions, and practice as well if you wish, and get in touch with other group members if you like. So lots and lots of perks and benefits for a really affordable price, and I'm giving away all my life's work literally for you, and lots of freebies. You know how I like to be generous, and my main concern is for you to learn Lebanese and to get your hands on some good quality resources, because we do have a big lack of resources in Lebanese. So go ahead and have a look at the course. And one final thing is that people who enroll now, like in within this period of time, they're gonna get free access into my next future courses, which will be about verb conjugation and reading comprehension. So that's a special offer for the time being only. So let's cut it short and begin with the lesson. So let's pretend first that we're in lost property. الممتلكات المفقودة. In Beirut airport, that would be called الأمتعة المفقودة. In Dubai airport, ممتلكات المفقودة. ممتلك is a possession. مفقودة means lost. And if we say شخص مفقود, that means a lost person, for example. So ممتلكات مفقودة, lost property or possession. Basics of location and direction. For is up or above or on, literally on or at a higher place, and we'll come to that. So it could also mean ala or a, on something, or it could mean up or above as well. Taht, below, under, down. So all of that is called taht. For example, if let's say now I'm in a building, أنا ببناية, neighbors, الجيران, جيران فوقي, the neighbors above me or on top of me or upstairs, الجيران تحتي are the neighbors below me or under me or downstairs. يمين, right, شمال, left, and to help you remember, I've got a little brainy trick over here, the L in English and the lam in Arabic, but they're pointing in opposite ways. Shmail. Also in formal Arabic, we commonly say yasar. So if you see that written somewhere, yasar, that also means shmail. So it's important to know some standard. It will help you a lot with things, because we rely on standard for formal communication. So it's good to have some kind of basic knowledge. Ben. Just like you say between in English, it starts with a B and an N again. Bain is the same, and you can say bainet as well. قدام is in front of, قدام, and we pronounce the qaf as a glottal stop, قدام. وراء is behind. In standard, that would be وراء, but we drop the hamza over here. It's just وراء, وراء. So, for example, over here, وراء الكرسي, قدام الكرسي. حد is next to, or we can say جنب as well. So, حد الكرسي, جنب الكرسي. And there's a specific video for prepositions. And that's like a longer version video with all the synonyms that we use in Lebanese and different ways of pronunciation, because you get more than one term sometimes for the same thing. هلأ دوركم, now it's your turn. ساعدوني لي الشنطة. ساعدوني لي الشنطة. Help me find the bag. وين الشنطة؟ الشنطة, fill in the blanks, ملوا الفراغ, الشنطة, طاولة. So there's two ways of saying it. Remember I've mentioned على and for. So we can say على الطاولة, on the table, as simple as. And sometimes we contract على with ع, so we can say على الطاولة. Or we can say الشنطة فوق الطاولة, so on or above the table, فوق الطاولة. And sometimes if something like is literally a bit above, like as in there's some space here, so kind of something is floating above, we also say فوق, فوق. So we can say, for example, عصفور على الشجرة, the bird is on the tree, or we can say فوق الشجرة as well, so above the tree, so implying that, you know, is flying above or something, فوق الشجرة. Okay, under or below, الشنطة تحت الطاولة, تحت الطاولة, الشنطة تحت الطاولة. What about now? الشنطة behind الكرسي, الشنطة وراء الكرسي, وراء الكرسي. In front of the chair, in front of الكرسي, الشنطة قدام الكرسي, قدام الكرسي. Okay, so you might have come across, if you're reading a book, المقدمة. مقدمة is the intro, introduction. So hence, قدام. In standard, that would be قدام. But in Lebanese, we say قدام. So أعد بالمقدمة. He sat in the front. And in standard, you have أمام or أمام in Lebanese. أمام. So for example, أعد بالصف الأمامي. He sat in the front row. That's versus خلف in standard, الصف الخلفي, so the back row. So again, it's important just to be familiar with أمام and versus خلف, so front versus back in standard as well, because you might come across them. Okay, brilliant. ممتاز. الشنطة. Now next to حد الكرسي. حد الكرسي أو جنب الكرسي. جنب الكرسي. Between, remember the trick, the ب and the نون, بين, بين الكرسي والطاولة, الشنطة بين الكرسي والطاولة. ساعدوني لاقي أشياء تاني, help me find other things. وين الأنينة, أنينة المي, the water bottle, أنينة المي. أنينة المي على الطاولة, على الطاولة أو فوق الطاولة. We can say حد اللابتوب, حد اللابتوب. لابتوب على الطاولة أو فوق الطاولة. لابتوب حد أنينة المي. المفتاح, وين المفتاح؟ المفتاح تحت الطاولة, تحت الطاولة. الشنطة حد الطاولة, next to the table, أو حد الكرسي, next to the chair. الشنطة قدام الكرسي, in front of the chair. بين الطاولة وبين الكرسي, between both. البرنيطة, the hat, البرنيطة على الكرسي. الكتب وراء الكرسي, الكتب وراء الكرسي. Going back here to say something is facing, we can say بوجه, بوجه. So for example, بوجه الكرسي أو بوجه الشباك. Facing, وجه is a face, so facing بوجه as well. And again, you can go back to that specific video which explains and lists all of that in detail. Conversation between two people. One of them is called Kareem. وين ساكن يا كريم؟ وين ساكن؟ Where do you live? ساكن is an active participle of verb سكن يسكن, verb to live. We commonly use the active participle when we're speaking about where do you live. We don't really say وين بتسكن, we say وين ساكن or وين ساكني in the feminine. ساكن بهيديك البناية بآخر الشارع ورا الصيدلية. So ساكن, that means أنا ساكن. If it was a female, she would have, if it was كريمي, for example, she would have said أنا ساكني. But he's a male, so أنا ساكن بهيديك. So هيديك, that. This هيدي, هيديك, that. And again, there's a special video if you want to go back to demonstratives in Lebanese. هيديك البناية, that building, بآخر الشارع, in the end of the street. If it was at the beginning of the street, I would say بأول. So أول versus آخر. So ordinal numbers and the, you know, the when we're ordering something, الأول is the first, الآخر أو الأخير is the last. آخر الشارع, the end of the street, the end of the street. ورا الصيدلية, behind the pharmacy. So the building is behind the pharmacy. ورا الصيدلية. في نادي رياضي قريب. So when we ask, is there something or something existing, we're going to use في. في, that means something is. ما في, something is not. So في, you're asking, is there? في نادي, is there a gym? نادي is literally a club or something like that. نادي رياضي is a sports club or what we call a gym. And if you just say نادي, in short, people will know you're speaking about a gym in general. So في نادي رياضي قريب, is there a nearby or a close gym? قريب, which is the opposite of بعيد. Let's write that down. So opposite of بعيد. قريب, opposite of بعيد, far. إيه, في نادي على يمين الدكان. دكان is a small shop in Lebanese. So دكان, دكان هون والنادي هون. Here. So النادي على يمين الدكان. On the right side of the shop. حدو دغري. Next to it, directly. دغري. Next to it, directly. حدو دغري. وكمان في جنيني صغيري. So جنيني, same as حديقة, garden or a park. كمان, and also, في, and also there is, جنيني صغيري. So if there wasn't, you would have said, لا, ما في نادي. لا, ما في جنيني. And so on. وفي مدرسة شي. And is there a school, by the way? Sometimes we add she at the end of questions, like kind of like, by the way, hey, something like that. So, في مدرسة شي. إيه, في مدرسة على شمال الدكان. So, المدرسة على شمال الدكان. On the left-hand side of the shop. هونيك. There. هونيك. هون, here. هونيك, there. في موقف للباصات قريب من هون. And is there a bus stop close by from here, literally. موقف is a parking. موقف. You know, يوقف means to stand or to stop. So موقف is the place where you stand or stop. It's the name of a place. أكيد, for sure. أكيد في. For sure there is. شي 50 متر من هون. About 50 meters from here. شي can also be used to mean approximately or around, like حوالى تقريبا. حوالى 50 متر من هون. شي 50 متر من هون. يعني approximately. We don't know for sure. And you can also use different words. You can use a verb, بيبعد. So بيبعد, that means it's literally far away from here, like but in verb form, بيبعد. 50 متر من هون. That is, الموقف بيبعد 50 متر من هون. Or you can say على مسافة 50 متر من هون. So the distance is about, is 50 meters from here. على مسافة is distance. على مسافة 50 متر من هون. So you can use different ways of saying the same thing. People, الناس, in the previous lesson we spoke about what's the meaning of insane, bashar, insani. So you can go back to the previous lesson about that, about describing people's physical appearance and personality. Makan is a place. Makan and amakin in the plural. So makan actually would in Lebanese, makan. Makan and amakin in the plural. There are other synonyms which we'll come to later on. So the name of a place, ism al-makan in Lebanese Arabic or in Arabic grammar as well. Normally you have three main patterns. Maf'al, maf'al, maf'ala, or maf'ali in Lebanese. So maf'al, maf'al, maf'ali. Manzil, for example, is the bookish term or the fusha, a standard term for bayt, manzil. Okay, maqha as well, the standard term for a coffee shop, maqha. Mat'am, a restaurant, mat'am. So you can notice a certain pattern here. Madkhal, entry or entrance. Makhraj, exit. Makhraj. Masjid, masjid, a mosque or jami', as we know, jami'. Knisi is a church, obviously, knisi. Ma'bad is the place where you, mahal ma bta'abad, is the place where you worship, ma'bad. So you can notice a common pattern in most of these words, obviously not all of them. For knisi and jami' don't follow this, the same thing. But you can notice maf'al, madkhal, makhraj, ma'bad. Or maf'il, masjid, manzil, mat'am. So you can notice the pattern, maf'al, maf'il. And sometimes you have maf'ala, like madrasa, but in Lebanese we say madrasi, because you know we like the A sound. So madrasi, madrasi. So these are the common ones. Basically, maf'al, maf'il, they're from derived from verbs that are based on three letters. But to derive names of places from verbs more than three letters, there's another way of deriving that, which we're not, that's not the main point in this lesson, but just to familiarize you and give you a general idea of, you know, what you will come across when you're speaking Lebanese. So anytime you hear something that starts with ma, like maktabi, matar, hatat al-metro, you may assume that it's the name of a place, especially if it fits with maf'al, maf'il, maf'ali. So maktabi, like madrasi, maf'ali, is a library where you read. Na'arif inno katab means to write. Katab, yiktub. Maktabi is the place where you study and write. Matar, airport, place of flying, literally. Tar, that means verb to fly. Tar, itir. Matar, the place where planes fly. Not you, but planes fly, literally. Mhatta, mhatta as well, is a station. So mhattat al-metro, mhattat al-train, train station or metro station. Markaz, markaz is a center as well. Markaz, maf'al, markaz. Markaz tijari, commercial center, literally. Commercial center. And we mentioned nadi is a club. Nadi Riyadi, a gym or a sports place or gym. Mahal is a place. So we can say dikkan is a little shop in Lebanese. Mahal is also a shop. For example, mahal tiyab, a shop for clothes. And you'll find in Lebanon, those little shops, we call them mahalat, little shops, like mahalat tiyab and so on. So mahal, it's very common in Lebanese. Mahal is a place. Now, getting to a certain place, if we want to ask somebody how to, do we get to a certain place, kif, busal. So, for example, kif, busal, al-matar. How do we get to the airport? Kif, busal, al Hammam to the toilet. كيف بوصل على المطعم? How do I get to the restaurant? كيف بوصل على الحديقة أو على الجنينة? How do I get to the garden or park? كيف بوصل على محطة الترين؟ How do I get to the train station? Obviously, you can simply say when. Where? When? When المطار? When المطعم? So over here, we have useful verbs and expressions that are helpful to give directions in Lebanese. Or when somebody is giving you directions, you'll be able to understand what they're saying. This is, by the way, updated from the last video. If you've, there was a lesson about that, but this is more in an expansive way. So دغري can mean straight. So روح دغري. Go straight or directly ahead. دغري. حد is next to something. هون, obviously here. هونيك there. روح. Go. روح دغري. Go straight. روحي دغري. Addressing a female, we're going to use the A. روحي. So روحي دغري. لقدام to the front. So I can say روح لقدام. Go to the front, روحي لقدام, بعدين, and then, وبعدين, رجع لورا, and then, go back, وبعدين, رجعي, رجعي, in the feminine, addressing a female. روح يمين, روحي يمين, روح شمال, روحي شمال, وبعدين, رجعي لورا, and so on. خليك, stay on something. خليك على اليمين, stay to the right. خليكي على اليمين. Lift, take a turn. Lift من هون, take a turn from here. أو lift على اليمين من هون. Take a turn to the right from here. أو لفي, لفي من هون. Take a turn from here. You can also say خود وخدي. Obviously, in the standard way of writing is with the ذا, but we commonly pronounce it as ذا. So خود from verb أخذ. خود هالشارع. Take this street, or خدي هالطريق, take this road. So, verb to take. Important things to know. إشارة ضوئية, إشارة is a sign. إشارة ضوئية, ضو يعني light, ضوء in Arabic. So, إشارة ضوئية, traffic light. دوار is a roundabout, دوار. And we know دويرة is a circle. Oh, mustadira as well. It's called mustadira as well. So it's just a synonym. And we commonly use, to be honest, the French word rond-point. So you can use either. So you come across both. Makhraj is an exit. Makhraj. Tariq is a road. Tariq. Mamar al-mushat, pedestrian crossing. Mamar is where you walk or cross, mamar. Mushet, that means pedestrians. Mushet. Okay, mafra is a turn. So, khod hal mafra al yamin. Take this right turn or the turn on the right. Taqatu' aw taqatu', because we like to pronounce the qaf as a glottal stop. Taqatu' is an intersection. Taqatu', where two roads are literally crossing or cutting each other, from ata to cross or to cut something. And we say yqta' al-tariq, that means to cross the road. Ana am biqta' al-tariq, I'm crossing the road. Common places again, al-mat'am, al-markaz al-tijari aw al-mall as well, aw center. All synonyms, محطة الترين, الحمام, المدرسة, المكتبة, الحديقة, أو الجنينة, السوق, الجامعة, أو الكنيسة, over here, القهوة, أو الكافية as well, we commonly say كافية, مخفر الشرطة, أو المخفر, police station, والمطار. For example, let's say you want to get to the restaurant, امشي أو روح دغري, أو خليك دغري, stay on straight ahead, وبعدين لف يمين وامشي دغري وبعدين لف شمال. أو خد هالمفرق على اليمين, امشي دغري, خد هالمفرق على اليمين, خليك دغري وبعدين روح الشمال وبتلاقي المطعم. and you'll find the restaurant. بتلاقي المطعم على إيدك اليمين, on the right hand side. So that's important to know. عايدك اليمين. Very commonly we say that. عايدك اليمين, on your right hand side. أو عايدك الشمال, on your left hand side. Obviously if it's a girl, عايدك اليمين, عايدك الشمال. On the right hand side, on the left hand side. Okay, if you're in the airport, some common terms. مطعم, السوق الحرة, محطة القطار أو ترين. Let's say you're in Dubai airport, الحمام, مصلى is the prayer room. Transit أو مواصلة الرحلات. مواصلة يعني to continue something. رحلات are journeys or trips. So you can, the continuation of journeys, the literal translation. بوابة is a gate, البوابة رقم واحد, البوابة رقم اثنين, المقهى أو الكافيه, الشرطة. القادمون يعني it's an active participle, those who are arriving, so what we call arrivals in English. المغادرون, those who are departing in the plural, so an active participle as well, which means departures. So it's important to know these terms as well. So let's say we want to get again to let's choose something different. البوابة رقم واحد, كيف بوصل على البوابة رقم واحد؟ ساعدوني. Pause the screen and try to help me. أنا هون بالمغادرون, let's say. We can say خليكي دغري, stay to the right, بعدين لفي على اليمين ومشي دغري, وبعدين فوتي, enter, فوتي على اليمين أو لفي على اليمين, وبعدين بتلاقي البوابة رقم واحد بوجهك, facing you, or حدك, next to you. So different ways. What about السوق الحرة؟ خليك دغري, لف على اليمين ومشي دغري, بعدين بتلاقي السوق الحرة على إيدك الشمال, and then you'll find the duty free on your right hand side. Okay, so now countries and continents. بلد is a country. بلد, من أي بلد أنت؟ From which country are you, literally, which country are you from, that is in English. أو من أي بلد أنت؟ أي أو أي, both are the same. There's different ways of saying the same thing, and they mean which or what. For example, أي كتاب عم تقرأ, what book are you reading, or which, literally, book are you reading. أنا من لبنان, أنا من كندا, etc. We know that. وين ساكن أو وين ساكنة, I've explained that earlier. أنا ساكن أو أنا ساكنة, I live in. And we're using the active participle over here. For example, let's say you live in a city. City is مدينة. قرية is a village. العاصمة is the capital. العاصمة. So أنا ساكن بمدينة بيروت. I live in the city of Beirut. أنا ساكن بقرية الشوف, in the village of Shuf. أنا ساكن بالعاصمة بيروت, in the capital Beirut. So different examples. Just be mindful, مدينة is a city, but when you're annexing a noun like مدينة بيروت, the sound is gonna change to it. So مدينة, you're not pronouncing the round تا at the end, it becomes an e sound, but when you have noun annexation, it's going to change. It's going to become it. مدينة بيروت. Same thing with قرية. أنا ساكن بقرية. I live in a village. Full stop. أنا ساكن بقرية الشوف. It. So there's an it ending when you're annexing a noun that ends with the round تا. العاصمة. العاصمة, the capital. Okay, so بلد is a country. In the plural, we can say بلاد أو بلدان أو بلدان. So you might hear it in different ways. بلدان أو بلدان. And earlier we said مكان is a place. We can also say محل. محل is a place, and it could mean a shop as well, as I've explained earlier. أماكن أو محلات, places. Also another synonym is مطرح. مطرح is a place. For example, تعرف شي مطرح حلو نسهر فيه. Do you know any nice place that we can go out, stay out for the night? مطرح. In the plural, مطارح, places. سياحة is tourism, And when we say sayih, sayih, it comes from the standard sayih with the glottal stop, what we commonly will swap it to the ya, sayih. Sayih means a tourist, and the plural is suwah. So sayih in the singular and suwah means tourists. So there should be an S over here, tourists in the plural. شو الأماكن السياحية المعروفة بي? What are the well-known touristic places in? So سياحية means touristic. سياحة, tourism, سياحية, touristic. So we're adding the suffix at the end. Just like in English, you add a suffix. We're using the ya of attribution over here. So for example, لبنان, Lebanon, لبناني. You're adding the ya at the end, just like you say Lebanon, Lebanese in English. So you're adding the ESE suffix. Same thing over here. سياحية, touristic. شو الأماكن السياحية المعروفة بلبنان أو المعروفة ببريطانيا, etc. في, there is, we can say في فندق كذا كذا, something. فندق الشيراتون, في, أو hotel, we commonly use hotel as well from French. في hotel الشيراتون, etc. الموفمبيك, so on. في مكتبة blah blah blah, كذا كذا. في متحف كذا كذا. متحف is, by the way, museum, متحف. جبل أو جبال, mountain, mountains. بحر is a sea. شط is the beach. بحيرة, lake. برج is a tower, برج إيفل مثلا. For example, مطعم, a restaurant, حديقة أو جنينة. So different nouns and vocabulary that you can use for touristic places. أثار يعني relics or ruins. يعني مثلا ببعلبك في أثار أو أثرات as well معروفة أو بصور أو بصيدة etc. So أثار يعني relics or ruins. You can practice if you like by dropping a comment and letting me know شو الأماكن السياحية المعروفة ببلدكم that are well known in your country. Directions, الشمال, north, الشمال, الجنوب, the south, جنوب, الشرق is the east, الغرب, the west. الشمال, الجنوب, الشرق, الغرب. Okay, continent, قارة, and in the plural, قارات. قارات, a continent, قارة. قارات الأرض سبعة, so the continents of earth are seven, وهن, and they are Asia, Australia, Europa, Afrika, and we commonly pronounce it as Afrika. So you can either say the proper standard way, Afrika, or you can say Afrika, as we commonly say it in Lebanese. America, الشمالية, America, الجنوبية, وأنتاركتيكا أو القارة القطبية الجنوبية. So we have seven continents. If we look over here, Asia, Australia, أوروبا, أمريكا الشمالية وأمريكا الجنوبية. إفريقيا أو أفريقيا. So either or. إفريقيا in standard Arabic. In Lebanese we say أفريقيا, to be honest. أنتاركتيكا. Same pronunciation, and it's commonly known in Arabic as القارة القطبية, القارة القطبية الجنوبية, so the southern polar continent. أو القارة المتجمدة الجنوبية, so the frozen southern continent. So you might come across different terms. Well, just to save you the headache, you can just say Antarctica. So as simple as. إذا عندكم أي أسئلة, please كتبوا بالcomments box if you have any questions and let me know. Thank you for your following. شكرا للمتابعة وشكرا للمشاهدة. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. بشوفكم بالفيديو الثاني.